This was revealed during the closure of a three-day academic theory and practical national seminar for over 1,000 students from 50 nursing schools in Uganda at St. Ambrose Institute of Health Sciences in Kagadi District.
Upward traction, the procedure delivered and the lesson delivered by.
According to Moses Baguma, the president of Uganda National Association of Students for Nursing and Midwifery, many nursing students are beaten and are brutally treated by their supervisors during internship, which instills fear among students and tarnishes the image of their profession.
Ga private go galistabon nyo usanga ngaga kuba abayizi.
Nursing students are beaten during their training. Videos are captured and uploaded on social media. When a patient sees a nurse being beaten, it tarnishes the image of our profession. He further asked the government to intervene on high tuition fees as well as high transport costs during academic and practical seminars and workshops.
We need the government to come up and help us in giving scholarships, because there are many scholarships on government, there are many scholarships on state house to these students, because you see these courses, they are too costly, the school fees are high. But if the government comes up and help these students and top up, at least we can have a good number of health workers, because today the health workers we are having in the country are not.
Birunji Harriet Nsamba, the senior principal officer, Technical Institute, Vocational and Entrepreneurship Training Program and the Ministry of Education and Sports, who represented the Commissioner Health Education and Training, Dr. Safina Musene, asked students to abide by their profession and desist from unethical behavior and revenge.
Such and other similar trainings are done to prepare you to become state health workers. However, there are some voices which signal that some of the nurses and midwives who qualify are not confident. So for us, we are going to endeavor that whenever we are told to go for practice in the hospital, let us endeavor to be there and get those skills, okay?
Masereka Emilio, the principal at St. Ambrose Institute of Health Sciences. Masereka Emilio asked the government to recruit more medical workers, open up medical schools and fund private nursing schools because they supplement government programs by training medical personnel.
Recruitment of students versus the qualified staff. Many health training institutions face a challenge of qualified staff. So I would request that the government would open space for many schools that can able to train tutors so that we increase on the number that would be available for most of the schools that are now opening. And then number two, looking at probably the entry requirements, you find that students, schools are faced with a challenge where getting the real, would be qualified students who meet the criteria, because the entry requirement probably has been put at a certain level and we may not get those very students that we need.
Report by Anjumu Singuzi for the news.